Hi, folks. Are you a Christian, but you come from a terrible past, and that past just haunts you every day? I really wish you would listen to a message from our pastor, Dean Hemphill, as he talks about, from the Bible, how to be free from your past.
The 4th of July, we celebrate freedom, liberty. But many people on that day, around the grill, doing activities with their family and friends, are not free. I want today to talk about that from the Word of God. The Word is free. I'm going to read from Galatians 5 and verse 1. The Apostle Paul from the Spirit penned these words. Stand fast, therefore, in the liberty, that word means freedom, wherewith Christ hath made us free, and be not again entangled with the yoke of bondage. Now, this verse 1 of Galatians 5, my first point is, we don't make ourselves free. I think many people, even Christians, are trying to make themselves free and do not realize they're free. Still, through religion and our own efforts, we're trying to make ourselves free. Now, this verse gives us the answer. Galatians 5:1, Christ hath made us free. Notice the word made. We don't earn it. We can't buy it. It says Christ has made us free. When someone receives Christ as Lord and Savior, at that same time, the dividend with that salvation is freedom. Christ hath made us free. We're made righteous through Him. Everything is made. Christ accomplished it. He done it. And through Him, He makes us what we are. Now, my second point is this. Then we are to be steadfast, affirm. Galatians 5:1. Stand fast or stand firm in the liberty. Stand firm in the freedom. Once you realize that Christ has made us free, He says, now you stand in it. That's our responsibility. You're free. I've done it. But you stand in it. You live free. Now, I'm going to go to my third point. What we are to watch out for. Once we realize in the Word of God He has made us free, and you and I standing in it, what to watch for. Galatians 5:1 again. And be not entangled again with the yoke of bondage. Now back in this time, when Paul penned these words, they were going back to the law. They were trying to go back to the rituals of the law. And Paul is saying from the Spirit, don't go back there. Don't be entangled again with the yoke of bondage. Because the law could not set anybody free. Today, we're not talking about going back to the law so much, but we are entangled by other things that creep in our lives. Christ has made us free. We've been saved. He says, okay, you stand in that. You stand in that. Be steadfast. Then, watch out for this. Do not be entangled again with the yoke of bondage. The word bondage means slavery. Becoming a slave to certain things. I'm going to bring out two ways today you can be entangled with the yoke of bondage. I think these two things right here is common among Christian people. Number one, our past. I think so often a Christian with a lack of the Word of God in their heart fall for the being entangled with their past. And don't realize from Scripture the past has been taken care of. Now, in our brain, we remember the past. In our heart, we should get rid of it. Now, if we don't, the devil makes sure, and religion makes sure, that this past keeps coming in our life. And the past, our past, if I think on my past very long, it's going to entangle me. Because my past is not what it should have been. And I'm not perfect today. But the devil will make sure he'll bring your past up to you and remind you, because the Bible says he's accused of the brethren, he'll accuse you and remind you of your past. And he'll convince you, if you're not careful, you're not even saved now. Look at your past. So the second thing I think is so common is not only the past, but people. If you're not careful, people will put you into bondage. And you become a slave to what people are saying and what people want you to be. And you find yourself then trying to please people, when the Bible says we cannot please men and please God. And you allow yourselves to be in bondage all the time because people are never satisfied with you. And they're always finding faults with you. And they'll bring up the past to you too. So you got people, if you're not careful, will put you back into bondage that you don't even have because Christ made you free of it. And we allow the words of men, because the Bible says that life and death is in the power of the tongue, and we allow these words of death to put us back into bondage. I'm going to turn now to John 8, to two verses, verse 31 and 32. I want you to listen to what Jesus says. Then said Jesus to those Jews which believed on him, if you continue in my word, then you are my disciples indeed. Disciple means learner, student. If you continue in my word, then you are a learner and you are a student indeed. The next verse, and you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. That's our problem. We don't continue in the word, and we'll let the past and we'll let people enslave us because we have not continued in the word, and the word makes us free. You see, 4th of July, Independence Day, the people celebrate, and I'm all for it. Thank God in all our faults in our country. Thank God again for America, United States of America. I thank God for it. With all that's going wrong, it's still a great place to be. People are breaking in across the borders every day trying to get here because how God has blessed this nation. But many people on the 4th of July, and many people in church every single Sunday, if you would ask them to be honest, they would tell you, I'm not free. I'm enslaved. I'm in bondage. And all the time, Galatians 5:1 says, Christ has made us free. And all the time, he says, stand fast in it once I make you free. And all the time, Galatians 5:1 says, and make sure you watch out for being entangled again with yoke of bondage. This is not a one-time fix. We have to stay in the Word every day and realize from the Word of God the truth that makes us free. You say, put your hip heel. Are you free today? I sure am. Many, many years ago, I was set free of people. I'm telling you, in ministry, you got to have freedom of that. Because people and comments they make will put you in bondage. Many years ago, I was set free of that. And for the first several years in ministry, it kept me bogged down. It kept me in bondage. I was trying to please everybody, make everybody happy, and it got to me. And one day I realized, hey, if I can please God, that's all that really matters. And I found out by doing that, the people then really that are seeking God are happy with that. If you and I just try to please God, the ones that are really living the Christian life are happy with that you're trying to please God. Do not allow your past. Do not allow people to entangle your life again and forget, I have been made free. John 8 also says these words, if the Son, therefore, makes you free, you're free indeed. Enjoy the 4th of July, but most of all, enjoy the freedom that you have as a born-again child of Almighty God. Until next time, from Clark Chapel Baptist Church, we trust with God's help that you would have wonderful days.
when I met Jesus, He made me complete. He forgot.